Buggy Bear!
Welcome to Downtown City! My name is Blythe Baxter. My dad and I just moved here from my sleepy hometown. And this is where I live now. Well, I live above the Littlest Pet Shop, actually, with my dad. I love fashion, and I'm always doodling in my sketchbook. I'm hoping the sights and sounds of the city give me plenty of inspiration. The big city can be a pretty scary place, so I'm also hoping I'll make new friends soon. As I headed up to my new apartment, two girls surrounded me. New friends? Unfortunately not. They wanted me to go shopping, but after they insulted my clothes, I said, no thanks. They were so mean. They told me that the Littlest Pet Shop was going out of business, and they sounded happy about it. Of course, their father owned the competition, the largest ever pet shop. But seriously? That's how I first met the Biscuit Twins. The Biscuit Twins made me think about how much I missed my old town. But I just reminded myself that Downtown City was bound to be full of adventures. And I love adventures! While I was unpacking, I discovered a secret passageway in my wall. It was a dumbwaiter. When I climbed in, I ended up crashing down to the bottom floor, right into the Littlest Pet Shop. When the dust settled, I couldn't believe what was happening. The pets were all talking about me, and I could understand them. What the what? When I started talking back to them, the pets were a little scared at first and hid amongst the shop's supplies. I was still a little shocked myself, but was able to coax each pet out of hiding to introduce themselves. Zoe is a former model. Pepper is the comedian of the group. Vinny is a fantastic dancer. Well, he hopes to be one day. Minka shares my love for adventure and art. Sunil is a genius at magic. Russell is the calm voice of reason. Penny Ling is super sweet and loves rhythmic gymnastics. Just then, the owner of Littlest Pet Shop, Mrs. Twombly, walked in. She seemed very sweet. Turns out these adorable pets are all part of her pet day camp. But unfortunately, the largest ever pet shop was scooping up all her business. And if things didn't get better, she'd have to close down. I was so sad thinking the shop might close. Those poor pets. When I returned to the apartment, my room was a huge mess. The pets had overheard Mrs. Twombly and sneaked up to my room to ask for my help, seeing as I could understand animals and all. Again, what the what? I knew we would come up with a great idea soon. But first, we needed to clean up my messy room. I started my first day of school just trying to get my locker open. I tried like 5 times, but it wouldn't budge. Luckily, some really nice kids stepped up and helped me out. Jasper Jones had my locker last year and showed me how to get it unstuck. His friends, Sue Patterson and Young Me Song, were also nice. They all knew about the Littlest Pet Shop and were very sad to hear it was closing. They also knew all about the Biscuit Twins. I wasn't surprised to learn they were the official mean girls of the school. My new friends invited me to eat lunch with them, and I was so excited, but also a little distracted. I still had to come up with an idea to save the Littlest Pet Shop. Suddenly, the Biscuit Twins walked up and asked me to eat with them. When I said no thanks again, they grabbed my sketchbook and tore up the pages. I was so upset, but it gave me a great idea. Combine my designs with each pet's talents, and we could have an awesome fashion show to save the pet shop. I needed to piece the designs back together right away. Once I had the sketches back together, I told Mrs. Twombly and the pets about my plan, and everyone loved it. When the pets cheered, all Mrs. Twombly heard was animal chatter, but I knew better. The show would stir up excitement about my pet fashions and the only place to buy them, Littlest Pet Shop. The event had to happen tomorrow if we were going to save the Littlest Pet Shop, so I worked all night with the pets, sketching ideas, gathering fabric, and sewing their outfits. The pets were so helpful. Just before the show was going to start, Jasper rushed over with bad news. The Biscuit Twins had sabotaged our fashion show flyers by making it look like we were giving away free money to people who came to the show. That's money we sure didn't have, and people could get really angry. But we knew the show must go on. If our guests loved the outfits, maybe they would forget about the money? Sure, that's the spirit. But first, I had to get the pets ready for the runway. The Biscuit Twins kept trying to sabotage the show. They tried sneaking in disguised as cats and climbed up into the rafters to dump chocolate icing and kitty litter on us. Fortunately, Russell saved the day. And in spite of everything, the fashion show was a huge success. There was a large crowd, the pets showed off their talents, and my fashions, and everyone had a great time. What a finale! The next day, the Littlest Pet Shop was packed full of customers. Pet owners were buying My Blythe style fashions for their pets, and Mrs. Twombly was having trouble keeping up with all the orders at the register. I told her I would be happy to help, and that's when she hired me to work at the Littlest Pet Shop. The best job a girl could ask for. I was so proud to save the pet shop, and so happy that I would get to spend more time with my new pet friends. The end.